All right, coming up any second now. 5S, 5 standard. Let's do it. Here we go. Boom. All right. Got the white side again. Let's try e4 again. Another caro? No. French defense. Okay. A Winawer. Let's try the Winawer. Paulson variation. And let's go e5. This could get very wacky. Very strategical. Now what? Do I want run and grab a pawn here? I'm not really a big fan of that. So, let's try something else. What could that something else be? Just knight f3? I like knight f3. And now what? I think eventually, okay, no, probably that right away. Because there is a variation where this bishop just plants itself on a4, provides a complete lockdown on the queen side, and then this king is allowed to safely go to that queen side, and I do not have a successful pawn break. Did you catch all that? I know I was rattling that off pretty quickly. I'll have to go back to that. It's a very important detail. You could find yourself strategically crushed, and then you'd kind of be scratching your head like, where did I go wrong? What could I do? Why am I not able to develop a cool plan? Well, it might be because this bishop is allowed to get to a4. Maybe. Anyhow, what should I be doing in the meantime? Bishop d3, bishop e2. This guy probably here, but not just yet. That would obstruct the rook's view of a4. Is there going to be a better spot than d3 for my light square bishop? Probably not. Okay. I'm coming here, and it may be very tempting to, as black, to play c4 because you're like, hey, I'm throwing a one-move threat at my opponent, but that, again, will resolve the tension in the center, and I will have to worry that much less about my d4 pawn. It's castle. I think rook to e1 is a purposeful move to run with. I do want to be in a position, I want to be prepared to meet takes with pawn recapture. And we might be having like knight c6, some takes, and then knight to b4 in some variations. I might want to be taking that into account, so knight c6, maybe bishop to d2. Also rook to e1 to meet c4 with maybe the bishop coming all the way back. I'm not quite sure. Or what about now, bishop to a3? I think bishop a3, knight a5, and then I have to do something about this guy. I don't know how great that's going to be. So, maybe I just allow. Yeah, I do have a plan. My plan is if they go with this capture and play knight to b4, I'm going to let my bishop just sit there and allow the knight to capture it, and I'm prepared to capture with my pawn. Now, again, the pawn structure will have changed. My bishop on d2, I think, will still be very well placed, maybe facilitating a5, maybe looking to pivot on b4 and then get on this diagonal. And now, bishop takes and then pawn push. Pressure on this guy. I could do g4, but that's an extremely committal move. Extremely committal. I think g4, eventually h4 will be coming. Black has not yet committed their king. Their rook is still on that h-file, so I don't know if I want to do that right away. Again, bishop a3, knight a5, g4. No, I don't really want to do that. How about... Bishop back? No. g4? Oh, I'm stuck. I'm stuck. My opponent's looking for weaknesses right here. They're trying to get me to do this move. I don't know if I want to do that move. Let's take that knight. He's too much of a pain. Oh, I'm winning this pawn. What am I doing? Oh, that's convincing enough. Oh, let's just open the position up. Why didn't I see that? These are all like pretty forcing moves, these capturing moves. Are they going to allow me to grab this pawn? They probably should hang on to it. Bishop e6, and if I'm going to take again, then this rook comes to life. But I'm not going to take. I think that this move is better. I don't want, again, I'm not taking here because that rook is going to spring to life. So now I'm big trouble. Where does this king go? Queenside castle? That's pretty crazy. If I get my bishop to d6, and it looks like I will be able to, my pawn has a difficult road ahead. These pawns are ridiculous looking, maybe. Tripled pawns, but again, one of them is just an extra. So less than two, my opponent three. I think I just gobble this guy up. Let's do that right away. I'm okay with giving that guy up. Maybe bishop to b4, bishop d6. Bishop d6. I like bishop b4. This is stringing everything together. Knight d4 is a nice home for my knight. Where does this king go? I think there's problems for the king. Knight d4. There is knight to b2. Maybe this is going to be a problem, but I'm just seeing bad things happening, like queen h5, and I'm threatening knight takes bishop here. If this pawn has to move, that's an additional dark square that my opponent's going to have to worry about, namely f6. My queen could also then be slipping into h6. So I have good posts for my minor pieces. This bishop is much more valuable. Well, it's worth more than 3 points. Let's say that much. So now let's get my queen out and about. Again, knight takes bishop is on the cards. Queenside castle, a5 could come very quickly. And now what? What does my opponent do? g6, again, queen h6. You're not getting rid of the queen so easily. There's only one minor piece and a bunch of pawns that can maybe chase her away, but that's okay. Now looking for g6 next. Okay, I like that move. Okay, well, how about I play f4? No. Let's not do that. Oh, wait, knight b5 to d6. Oh, man, this could be a really effective plan, right? Very, very effective plan. Not only is a bishop maybe strongly placed, earlier I was referencing a bishop there, but now a knight there. The knight is also two different squares available to it. Okay, so I'm gaining back some time. I think queen back here or just all the way back. I'm going to come all the way back. I think g5 was just going to be played, so I'm content with this. And if the knights are off the board, it's going to come down to an opposite color bishop ending. And as we all know, opposite color bishop endings are drawn, right? Not really, not in this situation. There's too much firepower. That's a passed pawn, and I did that to open up this e-file. Not only for my rook, but I want my queen to be able to pivot on these dark squares. So now, this is a big issue. A very, very big issue right here. I'm looking for queen f6, and then queen takes rook. Sneaking in right here. I think queen here is necessary. Rook takes bishop coming up. Also, just c4, bishop to c3 is on the cards. The queen has to go. I'm okay with giving up some pawns just to get my bishop on a better diagonal. Let's do this. And let's guard this passed pawn. My bishop was no longer there to watch over it. 31 seconds. If this bishop moves, rook to e7 is brutal. Okay. Let's do what? Let's move fast. Let's go here. I'm looking for maybe bishop d2, queen g4 stuff. Let's hang on to that pawn still. Dark square weaknesses. Let's back up. Now my bishop is extremely versatile, and now there's big problems. Mate in two. Dark square issues. Okay. This, if you take good game, this is, if you just take a quick snapshot, this is not like, it's not just by chance. Like when you, when there is those opposite color bishops, you know, sometimes like when you have those heavy pieces, you're going to want to be moving them about on light squares. And sure enough, in that final position, there's like, you know, you got all the major pieces, the queens and the rooks finding themselves on light squares, because otherwise this bishop could just be, harassing them. So, okay, let me back up. This, again, Winawer French could turn out to be very, very strategic game. This right here was one that I was speaking quite a bit about, well, as much as I could during the game. But this bishop d7 move comes with the thought of just cementing the bishop on a4. And I wish I could go into analysis mode right now, but I can't. So I could actually, instead of just rattling off the moves with naming coordinates, etc., I could actually move the pieces. But if I don't play a4, I think bishop to a4 turns out to be very strong. Maybe there's thoughts of, like, taking here and trying to hang on to it. But assuming, like, I can't, like, win materials in a successful way. Again, just this idea, bishop a4 is bishop a4 and then... something like c4 and then b5. How do I break that structure down? How do I break down a structure? If you can envision this pawn, excuse me, this bishop on a4, this black pawn just clamping down, just playing c4, and then as a follow-up, b5. So bishop on a4, pawn on b5, pawn on c4. How do I break that down? And what does this guy do? If these two pawns right here can't move, then this bishop is shut down on the queen side. And if h6 is played, what can this bishop do that's even constructive? So, you know, if you happen to be playing the white side of this, be very cautious of that idea. There is a difference. You know, black, I think, does well to maybe do this move prior to knight c6. If you do knight c6, bishop d7 would not be threatening to come there. So just switching the move order is making me do that a4 move right away. And that actually turns out to not be a good choice. And it took me a while to even see the variation where I could be netting a pawn. But would be something better. Probably castle or just maybe knight to a5. Again, I was prepared to meet, let's say, cd, cd, knight b4 with just bishop to d2, giving up my light square bishop. Knight takes bishop, pawn takes, and then with still opposite color bishops, I think I'm in a pretty decent spot. I have a lot of control over the entry points on the c-file. I think things would be all right there, but again, probably a knight a5 or... yeah, knight a5 I think is pretty good. I don't know. Decision time, or maybe h6, just kind of waiting a bit. Not allowing me to pivot on g5 with my bishop or knight. Maybe preparing like a queenside castle somehow. C4, timely c4, shutting down the queenside and then playing on the kingside is available. Again, there's so many, I think there's a handful of plans that black could be running with here. It's like it's a battle of plans at this point, a strategical battle. But I think after I net a pawn, I'm definitely better here. There's not really going to be anything good as far as I could tell. I don't know if I gave my opponent a window of opportunity anywhere. Yeah, it gets to be pretty rough here. Dark square weaknesses and a passed pawn. This bishop is obstructed by their pawn. So, all right, let's close out.